Hey everyone, welcome back to The Casual Puzzler. My name is Emily. Today we are going over puzzles that are on my wish list. I have five brands that I'm kind of stalking their web pages. If you've done any of these puzzle brands, please let me know. I know one's a recommendation from you guys already, but I'm really curious about trying more, or if you have another brand that you think I would be interested in, please let me know down in the comments. I'm just really wanting to find other puzzle brands to support, and so we are going over the five that have really sparked my interest, and I'll go over some that I've already purchased and then some that are on the radar. So the first puzzle brand that we are talking about is the Buffalo Game Puzzles. This is actually a recommendation from you guys. I remember doing a couple when I was really young, like in my 10, 11, 12 range. And so a few of you had mentioned in the comments that that is like your exclusive puzzle brand. And that is for good reason. Their pictures are beautiful. They have so many different ranges and varieties and collections. It was kind of overwhelming to choose which ones to buy. I did end up purchasing two, and then there's a few others I'll mention that are on my radar. So the two that I did end up picking up, we have this one here, which is called Color Challenge, and it is a gradient puzzle. It has like this like wavy texture in it, and I think Karen Puzzles has done this one, so I already knew that was like one that I was interested in, but in general I like doing rainbow puzzles anyways, and this looks super fun. The other one that I got is Moon Cycle, which this is larger for me. I normally don't go over the 1,000-piece range, and this is 1,500 pieces, and it has, again, a gradient rainbow, but it also has like this galaxy and this moon, and it has like this little mountain scene. It just looks really fun and vibrant. And I did realize the collection or the style of Buffalo Game puzzles that really sparked my interest is the Vivid collection or the Vivid puzzles. I don't know if it's a collection or if it's just a style that they do, but they're so saturated and they're so fun and they're very modern, and I really liked those graphics. So the two that are really on the top of my list right now is called Wanderlust and then Places You'll Go. I think they retail for around $15. In general, Buffalo Game Puzzles, their prices are really reasonable. I think their 500 is around like $12. Their the 1,000 piece puzzles are around $15, and then 1,500 I think was $20. So pretty affordable considering the size of the puzzles. I love to go camping. Me and Dave used to go all the time when we lived in Maine. Since then, we haven't had a lot of opportunities to go together, but I have been able to go on a couple solo trips. I'll put some pictures on the screen if you're curious, but I love to go camping, and these two just make me excited to go again. I'm thinking about doing something in the summer. I'm not sure if Dave will be able to come with me. The reason why he can't come is usually because of his work schedule versus my work schedule, so we shall see, but I'm really loving those graphics. They're very, again, vibrant. And then the other one that is really exciting to me is the Up, Up, and Away. I have a thing about hot air balloons. We live in Temecula, California, so hot air balloons go over our house every week. And actually, on Sunday, a hot air balloon landed in our neighborhood because it just couldn't get further. We have this thing about hot air balloons here, and I love this graphic. Again, very vivid and saturated, and they just look so fun. So thank you for that recommendation. I am so excited about discovering more from this brand. I may do one of these again on camera, so we will see when that happens. But thank you again. Let's just go into the next puzzle brand, which I have done one before. This is from New York Puzzle Company. I've done one which was called the Night Garden, I think. It was very dark. It was black, but it has like this really beautiful, vibrant flower border, and then there's like this little girl standing in the middle. Kind of remind me of like a storybook cover, and they do have a lot of puzzles that are like that. So it's like actual storybook covers. Like the two that I'm really interested in is the one for The Wizard of Oz, and they have one for Alice in Wonderland, and they just are like the book jackets. But then they also have like things from Harry Potter. They have a ton of Harry Potter ones. So if you have a Harry Potter lover in your life, you want to get them a gift, one of these puzzles might be a good option. They also have some really quirky ones, like Mr. Fly is like this little fly that's like riding a bicycle. I think it's so funny. It's like listening to NPR on the radio. Anyways, that one I'm really interested in. And then another one is called Moonlight Moment, and they're just all really fun and quirky, and they aren't crazy pricey. They're around like $18 to $20 depending on the size. The next puzzle brand is probably my favorite. As of right now, when I'm filming this, this is the puzzle brand I'm most excited about. I've done two of them before, and I cannot wait to get more. I actually have ordered them, but I had to pre-order them, so they won't come for a little bit. But I do have two to show you at least, and so this is Art and Fable. Art and Fable puzzle pieces are like any other. They almost have like a suede-like quality to them. They have a decent thickness, they snap really well. I love doing these puzzles, and I'm excited for the two that I purchased So this one here is Pearl River Village. And this one is a, almost looks like an oil painting. In general, their pictures look like art pieces. So this is a oil painting type puzzle. Maybe it is from like an actual famous painter. I'm not quite sure. But it has this really nice, pretty graphic. And inside they do have a print that you can frame or something to put on the wall, like a really nice sturdy print. And then it also has like a little like holder to like hold the picture up while you're doing it. It has a lot of nice little things for it. And then the other one that I have is called East of the Sun, West of the Moon, which is a storybook. And I love both of these. I love the quality. I love this feel of them. Like it just makes it really satisfying when you put your puzzle pieces in. The two that I pre-ordered were both their 1,000 pieces. They originally only did 500 piece puzzles within the past month or so. They've been launching a couple 1,000 pieces, and then you have their first 1,000 piece collection coming out soon. So I did pre-order a couple. One is called Window Nook. It's just a really pretty, again, looks like just art. Like I could easily see myself taking any of their puzzles and like taking them together temporarily to like hang on the wall. You know, I'm not gonna glue my puzzles together. I'm not that person. Like I would rather give that puzzle away to someone so they can do it versus gluing them together and like sticking it on the wall. Anyways, so that one I could see me actually like putting up somewhere temporarily and then taking down. And then the other one is La Nouvelle Femme, which is like this lady in the middle and then like ladies on the side. And again, it just looks like more of an art piece versus a puzzle. And I just, again, love the feel of them and the texture. They also, I did order one of their mystery puzzles. It's just like in a bag. It doesn't have a box. It's just like the puzzle pieces. So we'll see how that goes. I might do a video on that one. But the mystery puzzle was around $18. And then their 1,000 piece puzzles around $28, $29. I don't remember. I want to say their 500 piece puzzles around $22. So kind of up there in price, but again, they just feel so nice. Oh, also they have free shipping if you order from their website, if you buy three of their puzzles, which is why I bought three, or I normally go on Odyssey Fine Puzzles. So that's where I get my art and fable, but I am really loving this brand so far, and I want so many from them, but I'm trying to resist the urge. The next one, our brand number four we're talking about, is Cloudberries. I know they are super popular. I've never done one before. So they retail for around $25 for 1,000 pieces. They again have really fun saturated puzzles, and they look very modern. They definitely have more of a modern feel to them versus Art and Fable, which is more of like a classical Renaissance type feel to them. But this is a brand that I want, again, so many of. They're just really vibrant, really fun, very saturated looking pieces. I heard their snap is really good, and so I'm really curious about doing them. Two that are on my radar, plus all their gradient puzzles are on my radar, but I have Poolside and then Botany. They're both, again, very saturated, very quirky, very modern, and I'm really excited about trying that brand someday. And then the fifth brand is the most expensive. It's $36 a puzzle, but it's called Piecework, and they do have more of, again, a modern feel to them. They have a lot of like, I don't know if you would call them collages, but they remind me of those games where you would have like a graphic or an image and you have to like find the little images inside. You know what I'm talking about? I'm sure you do. I'm sure there's an actual word for it, like an image search or something. Anyways, but that's what a lot of their puzzles look like. Like the one that I really want is called Power Lunch, and that lunch looks crazy, where it's just like stuff everywhere. It reminds me of that 1980s with like the big giant phone in it. But they look really fun, and like I love puzzles where it's like easy to find where the piece goes because there's so much going on. Another one that I'm really interested in is Smoke and Petals. That one's definitely more of like an artsy one. It is very soft. That one I could definitely see me taping temporarily to like hang on the wall or as an art piece in my house, at least for a little bit. But that one's really pretty. But in general, they're just like fun, quirky, modern looking puzzles. Some more in like romantic puzzles, but in general, they look really pretty. There's two things that make me hesitant on this puzzle brand. One, they're kind of pricey. They're $36 a piece, but also all of their puzzle shapes are the exact same. So that's just not my favorite style. I'd much rather either have really wonky pieces or even just traditional puzzle shapes, but having all the pieces be the same size and shape, you know, it just gives it not as fun of a feel for me. But that's maybe just me. But I just think for that high of a price point, I'd want it to be a little bit trickier, or if I would want my puzzle shapes to just be the way that I want them to be. Well, that is it for me today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know again if you have done any of these, or what's on your radar, or what's on your wish list, so that I can maybe check out other puzzle brands that I need to know about. Or if you want to see me to do any of these puzzle brands first, please let me know and I'll put them on the docket of like the next one to buy. Anyways, thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.